Hello friends, welcome to this new lesson. This is the lesson number 36 in this series of British literature. In the previous lesson, we discussed Sir Thomas Wyatt, and now in this lesson, we shall discuss his friend Henry Howard. About Henry Howard, he was born in the year 1517 and died. In fact, he was beheaded. He was murdered or killed as a punishment in the year 1547. And 1547 he was killed at the command of King Henry the Eighth. About Henry Howard, he belonged to the royal family and he was called as the Earl of Surrey and a noble Englishman and one of the founders of the English Renaissance. He was also called as among the founders of the English Renaissance. And about his relation in the royal family, he was the cousin of the second Queen Anne Boleyn, the same which I discussed in the previous lesson, the second wife of Henry the Eighth, with whom Sir Thomas Wyatt had an affair, as a rumor it was said. So he was cousin to Anne Boleyn and also to Queen Catherine Howard, about whom as well I have told you in the previous lesson. So he had a good connection in the royal family. And one more thing was said about him. It was also somewhat like a rumor that he was a strong candidate or strong contender to be the heir of the King Henry the Eighth, because you know that Henry the Eighth didn't have any legitimate male child earlier from the first of his two wives. And then there was a theory or there was a saying that he was Mr. Henry Howard. He was somewhere conspiring to be the King of England. And but all these things came to nothing when King Henry the Eighth had a male child from his third wife or third marriage, we can say Edward. So after Edward, there was no such possibility that Henry Howard could become the king. So all these things ended in nothing. And there were some more you can say conspiracies related with him, and later he was considered as he was somewhere looking to murder or kill King, not King, but Prince Edward VI. I have told you that Edward VI, when he was born, he was not healthy enough, and there was a almost means everyone was saying that this child will not survive long. So somewhere it was said that Henry Howard was looking to eliminate this issue, Edward VI, so that he could become the king. But such things could not happen. He was found guilt for treason and later he was beheaded at the king's command. So he was beheaded in the year 1547. So everything, whatever rumor were there about becoming the king, everything came to nothing. Now, about his works, he is considered as the father of sonnets, English sonnets. I told you that in UGC NET question, it was asked that who were known as the father of English sonnets. So we have two names, Sir Thomas Wyatt and Henry Howard. And many people believed that because he died in the early age of up to 1547, he lived so almost 30 years he lived, and in those 30 years he produced so much good about these sonnets, and people believed that he could have become the master of sonnets, or means so famous with his sonnets, but it was never to be possible. And okay, he had that quality. Whatever the sonnets he produced in the past, those were quite good enough to speak the volume of his caliber. And the sonnets he produced later, his style and technique was mastered by Shakespearean, and later all these sonnets came to be known as the Shakespearean sonnets. So about him we don't have much to read or much to discuss here, but one thing we have to remember, that Shakespearean sonnets, maybe we are using the name Shakespeare, but we have to remember that these sonnets are modified or created by, this style of writing or of sonnets is created by Henry Howard. So about some questions, as I mentioned in the previous lesson as well, he was called as the father of English sonnets along with Sir Thomas Wyatt. And second, he contributed 36 poems in Tottle's miscellany, Richard Tottle, the publisher. In his miscellany, he contributed 36 poems and 15 sonnets. There were overall 271 poems, and it was published after his death, after the death of Sir Thomas Wyatt, and also after the death of Henry Howard. It was published in the year 1557. So posthumously it was published. And one more point, he was also called as the introducer of blank verse in English literature. Blank verse is simply a poetic form where unrhymed lines are written in iambic pentameter. So where you can see no means a rhythm, not much means sound, or we can say the ending of the lines is not so rhythmic. So that is called as blank verse, which is almost written in the form of prose. So he used blank verse. So another famous point, or point to be remembered, because it was also asked in the question, he used blank verse for translating Virgil's Aeneid. So remember this name, Virgil, the great Roman poet Virgil, and he had written Aeneid, famous work. And that work, there are several books in this work. So from these books, book 2nd and book 4th was translated by Henry Howard in blank verse into English, or modern English we can say. So remember Virgil's Aeneid. Just remember, Homer has written Iliad and Odyssey. So similar to that style of poetry or that epic poetry, we have in Roman culture or in Roman tradition, we have Virgil, who had written Aeneid. So these are the three major epic poem can be seen, Iliad and Odyssey in Greek tradition, and Virgil's, it is the name of the poet, and his work is Aeneid. Okay, so that's it about Henry Howard. So important points to be remembered, as his relation in the royal family, and he was beheaded, and he was called as the father of English sonnets, and he was friend of Sir Thomas Wyatt, and introducer of blank verse, and his contribution in Tottle's miscellany, 36 poems, 15 sonnets. So these are the major points which were asked in the previous year question papers. So that's it about Henry Howard. So I hope you have enjoyed this lesson, and hopefully I shall record the next lesson as well on another famous writer, that is Roger Ascham. So thanks for watching this lesson. Have a nice day.